Hello, so this is what happened when I started it.
Which have come to pass since the First World War, have highlighted the necessity for specialized troops, capable of undertaking specific operations within a general strategic framework. To this end, combat techniques for airborne troops, amphibious operations, sabotage, and reconnaissance missions have been developed. The requisites for troops performing these tasks are higher than those for other soldiers.
So when I loaded the same game, this video started.
Their presence and performance will be essential for the resolution of the conflict.
Nice, we get some elite infantry. Seems to be the same as when I left. Now we have access to elite troops somewhere. Okay, we'll need to find the area where we can get them. Maybe we can't get them from anywhere yet. We might need a building. We have the tech to get them, but we need a building, probably. Yeah. Barracks for elite troops. Yeah, we need such a building. Let's build one of those. Here we have the medium vehicle factory. We will go for it. No. It's the same area. Already constructing there. Let's get it here too. And here. And in this city. So you can get better infantry. Regular troops, okay. Elite troops. This was elite troops. Okay, we're done there. Believe it's time to attack. Get an army there. And the fleet. Move an agent into their area too. Keep an army here too in case they attack us. Sometimes the AI will choose to invade at the same time. We can send this fleet here. We will invade. We are ready. Move this army there in case Britain will arrive. Move this force towards the front there with the sea towards Britain. Okay, and this army could also be moved. Agent into the rest of Poland. Okay, so we'll fight France now. I have improved the graphics too. Okay, so the advisor says, my leader, once you have ordered all the actions you feel necessary, use the sand clock button to indicate. Yeah, I know that. Okay, and what about updates? I hit the wrong button first there. Technology. Let's go for some snipers. Maybe the paratroopers. Okay, let's click enter. So, Holland is invaded by the United Kingdom or the British Empire. I will call them the British Empire here. On 22nd September 1939, that was surprising. So Winston Churchill, he has 10,401 soldiers, we have 20,600 infantry, we have more. And we have 750, they have 750 tanks, we have 1,300 tanks. They are leading because they also have their naval power. So they can bombard us from the sea. Okay, we'll fight the battle. So we might lose it. We can't attack their ships, but they can attack us. We have no planes. But we have superior numbers in infantry and in tanks. German forces are attacked by British troops. So I'll group them. Group one. Now we need to find a supply depot. If there are any. It was unexpected. I expected to fight the French, but not the British. In this battle. On this end turn. So we have no supply depots either. Just empty land here. Here we have a civilian building. Yeah. Not what I was after. Bunker. Here we have a supply depot. It's far away. Here we have a little town. If there are any other supply depots on this map, there might be more than one. Here we have the British Army. Eight valve Matilda tanks, Matilda 2 tanks, similar to our Panzer 1 Josef F, better ones. Better Panzer ones. Then they have some artillery, the Ordnance, 6 PDR. Some Matilda tanks. And some artillery. They have some reconnaissance, Daimler SC cars. Machine guns. Some anti-aircraft. 40mm Bofors Portee. Bofors? They might actually be Swedish. Bofors is a Swedish name. Anyway. We are starting with this supply depot. We do not have our army here. It's far away. Okay. I'd like them to start at that supply depot. It's ours because they are attacking our area. Can't move them there too. that sucked. So move the arm over here. Start the battle. Move immediately up there. Not happy that I can't use the... Now I could. Good. So we have the best graphics on now. The sky is much better looking. You can see their ships in the distance, the British ships. The terrain is a little more beautiful. No lag here, at least. Ships might start to fire at us soon. Ships are really dangerous. Needed to attack before the ships take us out. Down. tanks and reconnaissance cars. We do not have any more vehicles. This is the last artillery piece. And all our tanks are gone. I can't scroll to another unit. I wonder if we have any infantry left. Still holding the supply depot. They got help from the sea in this battle. The heavy naval guns of the ships. Here comes the reconnaissance cars of the British. They will take us out, no doubt. They're being fired at now. Aircraft trap. Here we have some British soldiers. Machine guns. Their trucks. Have some infantry. We lost the battle. We killed everyone. So the British took Holland, I believe. Never think that war, no matter how necessary nor how justified, is not a crime. M.S. Hemingway. So Holland was lost to the British. Casualties, so we lost, I believe, the British lost 10,119 infantry troops out of 10,401, so they lost almost all their infantry soldiers. Then they lost 200 out of 200 tanks, 75 out of 200 artillery pieces. Or if it's anti-aircraft pieces, I'm not sure. No, it's artillery. And then 74 out of 100 anti-aircraft. 7 out of 150. Yeah, I don't know. This is artillery. This is... maybe one of them is anti-tank. Okay, 60 out of 100 reconnaissance cars. No ships. So we lost 20,600 out of 20,600 infantry troops, 400 out of 400 tanks, 200 out of 200 artillery pieces. Yeah, this is artillery. Okay, and we lost 300 out of 300 anti-tank artillery, and 100 out of 100 reconnaissance cars, and 300 out of 300 transport trucks and supply trucks. Probably thanks to their ships. Major defeat. Now the Battle of Lorraine-Alsace. Here we have 31,200 infantry. They have the upper hand. They have in infantry. They have 51,701 infantry. We have 2,700 tanks. They have 1,000 tanks. We have the upper hand in tanks. Then we have 1400 planes, they have 0 planes, and no one has ships. I believe this could go our way. Let's start the battle. Four elements make up the climate of war: danger, exertion, uncertainty, and chance. Carl von Clausewitz. a part of the main force. See if we have any supply depots where we can place them. Yeah, here we found one. We can place our trucks here. Defensive position. I will get this from the French immediately. Which is good. We had some supply trucks too, but they could actually be used to supply the army. There. Start the battle, pause the game. Want to take a look at the enemy. To the enemy army. There's some tanks here. Charlager, H-39. Okay. Looks similar to our Panzer 1 OSF-F in terms of their turret. Probably a little better. And they have infantry. Their infantry are looking like this. Have some machine gun infantry. Some paratrooper medics. Some riflemen. Oh, they have the general here. I think it's Charles de Gaulle, but it might be a different general, I'm not sure. Might be Charles himself. Okay. And they have some vehicles. Check them. So they have the reconnaissance cars. French version. Some supply depot trucks. Some artillery, really big artillery, heavy artillery. Look bigger than ours. So better artillery and better tanks. More supply depot trucks than we had. And then they have the tanks similar to our best ones in this battle. Probably slightly better. Okay, we have planes. They didn't have any planes. Let's start the battle. Let's send out our fighters. Not that they can do much. We have a lot of fighters in this. Total air superiority. By the way, I patched this game with a 4GB patch and a large address of air patch. I patched both exe files, so maybe that helped with stability. I'm also running it as an administrator and follow the guide to enable incompatibility mode for Windows Vista with some options enabled. It was necessary, but even with that it shouldn't have been stable. I believe the large adder server and 4GB patch might have helped instability. Makes the game able to read more than 2 gigabit. I believe it has the same issue as being 2 there. Probably. Okay, I might be wrong, but at least it's more stable than the last time I tried to play it in 2018. Here I couldn't fight a battle without it crashing a few minutes after the battle was over. They are attacking. We have an army on the other side of the river. So our guns are firing at them. They have long range. I want the enemy to make their positions. Alright, they have set up their positions. They have some anti-aircraft tracks too. Maybe I shouldn't have sent my fighters out. Didn't know they had that. We might take them out and we had no planes to fight anyways. It was a waste of my planes. Let's just send out the bombers against their aircraft trucks. We have a lot of bombers in this battle. Quite a few bombers here. Different gun. Is that 75mm field gun? Capitals are like this, but huge. So lights in the capitals, but not in the smaller ones. The attacker in this path. So aggressive mode is on and we have placed the units in attack formation. Let's just attack. Water in the water. They're firing from their water. Okay. I managed to send the trucks too. Not good. Maybe it's just the supply depot. Nice! Our bombers are arriving soon. Need us. See them in the distance there. French positions, the entrenched French artillery positions. Okay, how is the situation over here? What is the map saying? We lost a lot of their vehicles and artillery. Yeah, it's slightly more laggy when we have the best graphics with a large distance, but I enjoy watching it like this. It's a shame. It only lags when we have zoomed in on the character. They have some troops probably in the city too. I'm not sure exactly where. Here they have some troops in this building. Okay, we will send our fleet and
squadron.
buildings here. Just order the army to attack. The camera is a little annoying that we are on a hill or a mountain. Here's the enemy. French. They left the city. That's the last one. We might have won now. Might have someone else in the city. Yeah, there is a blue dot here. Yeah, they are in this building too. Let's bomb it. And attack it with the troops. Planes didn't even get. Alright, we won the battle. Pretty epic. It just sucks that it can't be lag free. Imagine huge settings without lag. I might need to buy a new computer. But there is no telling if the game will work as good on a new computer. It might not work at all. Okay, Lorraine, I'll suck. So we lost 29,989 troops out of 31,200 troops. We almost lost all our infantry troops. And the enemy lost 51,701 out of 51,701. They also lost 200. Tanks of the 200, tanks 100, anti-aircraft guns out of 100, and 300 artillery, no, maybe 100 artillery pieces out of 100, and 300 anti-aircraft out of 300, 100 reconnaissance cars out of 100 reconnaissance cars, and 300 trucks out of 300 trucks. We lost 14. I believe anti-tank guns. Ah, so it was anti-tank. They lost 300 anti-tank guns out of 300. We lost 800 tanks out of 800. We lost all our tanks. We lost 227 artillery out of 400. Okay, so we had about half our artillery pieces left and a very few infantry. We lost all the tanks. But we only lost 14 anti-tank guns. Like the pack 40s, I believe. And we lost 300 trucks out of, cars out of 300. Then we lost 21 fighter planes, I believe. We had 1400 planes. They had anti-aircraft trucks. Alright, we have the Battle of Champagne, too. Champagne. So we have 5441. Troops, they have 30,200. Then we have 1,343 tanks, they have 500. So they have the upper hand in infantry, we have the upper hand in tanks. Then they have 500 planes, we have 200. So they have the upper hand in planes as well. We will fight this battle too. I hope it won't crash. This will be the final battle before we end this episode. Don't want to play too much. I believe we have played about an hour already. It will be about 1.5 with the battle. Yeah, it didn't crash. French troops are attacked by German forces. So you're attacking another area of France. So you have some French buildings here, probably. It can be garrisoned. civilian building. Here we have a supply depot held by the enemy and more civilian buildings. Their army, we have infantry. Reconnaissance cars and even the aircraft trucks. Seems to only have riflemen this time. Yeah. And cars and trucks. No tanks. They are the defender, so they should have it. Okay. Start the battle. We want that supply area. We also want to send in our fighters and bomb their trucks. We need to let them move first. Their positions. Trucks to move there, move back. Our fighters are in the air fighting their fighters, I believe. They are taking us out. They have too much superiority. Fighters. They have too few in this battle. Get out. Still send in my bombers. Just need to take them out. They can also fight fighter plane. Slow down the battle. Here. fighting in the sky over there. Yeah, they are over there. Our bombers are over there, they are big planes. They are not entirely worthless against fighters, they can defend themselves. This location. Let's attack. Oh, I did a mistake. Planes have left. They are damaged. Lost a few too. Far too long to go there. Nation. Got to hurry up. That stance, we'll use the defensive stance instead. Okay, now. So they lay down on the ground instead of standing. Some machine gunners here now too. Are still moving over the bridge. As long as this game doesn't crash, it's actually really fun. I'm gonna do a Japanese campaign later. I also had an old Soviet campaign, so I probably want to replay that too. Then maybe an Italian underdog campaign, and maybe an American campaign. Maybe even a British one. The only faction I don't feel like playing is France, because I think their units have They have some good units, but I mean, their looks suck. I mean, America's troops didn't look cool, but at least we have the bombers, the planes. Bombers ready. Good. Don't send them against our own troops. We can do that, it seems. Send the bombers against this anti-aircraft track. Planes are on their way. I think that's our planes. Only three left and one is damaged. See the smoke from it. It's coming. Ah, there are the bombs. Look at the damage from the bombs on the ground. Make holes on the ground. Damage from the bombs. Okay. Battle. No ground gained was ever relinquished. General Matthew B. Ridgway. There might be another battle, but I don't think so. So, Champagne has been conquered. He lost 2,829 men out of 5,441. He lost about half our infantry, slightly above half. They lost all their infantry, 30,200, and then we lost 178 out of 400 tanks, and 143 out of 143 reconnaissance trucks. We lost all the trucks, and we lost 151 out of 200 aircraft. They lost all their infantry, they lost 400 out of 400 anti-aircraft guns, and then they lost 100 out of 100 reconnaissance trucks or cars, and then they lost 23 of their aircraft out of 500, so they didn't lose a lot of their aircraft. Most of their aircraft remained. Sniper techniques discovered. Cool.
Snipers have been in action since the 19th century. They also featured in the First World War, albeit with few resources and unrefined techniques. The improvements in weapon optics, which provide great precision, and improvements in camouflaging, make the sniper an indispensable element in the elimination of selected objectives.
Resource scattering anyway. Okay, economic summary. So we have Pioneer in Belgium. And buildings constructed, building construction finished. We have port in Mecklenburg-Vorpommern. And in Österreich we have a medium vehicle factory. Conquest of territories. Your nation has conquered Champagne. And your nation has conquered Lorraine, Alsace, both from France. And then your nation has lost Holland to the British. Okay, advanced combat techniques. So we have snipers, or at least the technique. Maybe not the building. Okay, enemy spy in Belgium has been caught while trying to gather information. Okay. The British have entered there. They have the guns. She isn't good. Move this army to Denmark. And this one to this area. Move some other troops. Closer to the... Now we can leave that army there. Army back. They conquered two areas in France. Okay. So Charles de Gaulle is of course still alive. As long as they have a territory left, I believe he can potentially retreat it if he loses the battle. Building construction. Aircraft factory. I could use that. Use some infantry here, maybe. In Champagne we can already do a lot of stuff. Build a lot of stuff. Could go for tanks or other stuff. Okay, we can go for some guns. That Britain will let me invade here. With this army. Into the area of Nordrhein, Westfalen. This area didn't have any building for planes. We can't move planes there. So we need an airfield. In the area we conquered, Lorraine, Alsace. An army into the area mostly infantry and artillery. Right, and I guess we should check this stuff. We want paratroopers, of course. Okay. And let's click and turn, but we will save here. I believe here is where the episode will end. So we saved. And yeah, thanks for watching. See ya.